Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I am Joycey Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about sustainable development in the context of Chennai Salem highway case. So if we look at the current affair, earlier the Madras High Court had quashed the proposal to acquire land for the Chennai Salem highway, and this was taken by the Tamil Nadu state government to the Supreme Court. So they filed an appeal in the Supreme Court against the judgment of the Madras High Court with regard to the Chennai Salem highway case. So now the Supreme Court will give its verdict on Chennai Salem highway case, and based on this we will understand the concept of sustainable development, what is the trade-off between ecology and economy, the economical benefits, at the same time the ecological impacts. So we will discuss all this in detail in this lecture. But before we begin, this is our channel StudyIQ and we are providing pen drive courses for various competitive examinations including UPSC Civil Services Examination. If you are preparing for Civil Services Examination 2020, you can avail our pen drive courses which covers 100% of the UPSC's vast syllabus, plus the daily current affair updates will be provided. You can find more details on the link which is provided on the description of this video. You can also visit our website for more details. So let us start. Let us first understand what is the current affair. Now the Supreme Court of India, the apex court, is to hear the arguments on the appeal filed against the judgment of Madras High Court. So what was the judgment of Madras High Court? So earlier the Madras High Court had quashed the land acquisition proceedings for the proposed Chennai Salem Greenfield Corridor. So the Madras High Court said that it is not environmentally sustainable if this project is carried on. So based on the ecological impacts of this proposed Greenfield Corridor or the highway that connects Chennai to Salem, the Madras High Court had quashed the land acquisition proceedings. Now the Tamil Nadu government gave an appeal in the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court will soon give its verdict in this regard. So this will make a potential current affair question for your upcoming UPSC mains examination, or the many concepts and facts that we will discuss in this video will be helpful for your preliminary as well as your mains examination. And this is also considered as a assessment of judiciary's concerns over environmental and economic interest. Now we will see the judiciary whether it will give more weightage to environmental concerns or the economic significance of this project. So taking all of this into consideration, this is a very important topic for your UPSC preparations. So let us start. Let us first understand what is the case all about. So the case relates to acquisition of land for the proposed 8-lane expressway. So this expressway will connect Chennai to Salem in the state of Tamil Nadu. So this 8-lane highway, it's a part of the Bharat Pariyojana project. It is a centrally sponsored highways program. So Bharat Pariyojana is a very important topic for your preliminary examination. You can see that the UPSC asks at least 2 to 3 questions based on government schemes. Bharat Mala Pariyojana is a very important scheme. It is a centrally sponsored scheme of the central government. So this expressway is a part of Bharat Mala Pariyojana. Now the chief objective of this corridor is the efficient freight movement between this area. So this intended highway will cover more than 250 kilometers. So considering the economic significance, that is in terms of trade and commerce, it has a huge economic significance. It will cut down the travel cost, it will cut down the cost of the movement of freights, etc. But if we consider the ecological or environmental impact of this, it will have significant harmful impact on the forest, on the surrounding water bodies and the wildlife of this region. So here the key contention is the debate over the need for an environmental impact assessment before the land acquisition. Now considering both the ecological and economical impacts, the Madras High Court said that the ecological concerns overweigh the economical significance. So in that regard, Madras High Court had quashed a series of notifications for acquiring land for this project. Now it is due with the Supreme Court. An appeal has already been filed in the Supreme Court, and now we are waiting for the verdict of Supreme Court. Now let us understand what is the government's stance in this regard. How did the Tamil Nadu state government respond to this? So the argument of the Tamil Nadu state government is that the power to acquire land is unconditional for the state government under the National Highways Act of 1956. So Tamil Nadu government argues that it has power to acquire land under the NHA or the National Highways Act of 1956, and this power is unconditional. And the state government also said that there was no law mandating an environmental impact assessment before efforts are made to acquire the private land. So this is the government stance or the argument of Tamil Nadu government. Now let us briefly understand how did the idea of sustainable development emerge. So it was in 1987 that the Prime Minister of Norway proposed some measures, some long-term strategies, and they were called sustainable development measures. So the whole idea was to meet the needs of the present generation without compromising the needs of future generation. So this is the idea of sustainable development. This is a very important concept. So sustainable development means the needs of the present generation can be met, but it should not compromise the demands or the ability of the future generation to meet their own demands. So in India, even before a binding agreement or a binding international norm was in place, the Supreme Court said that the idea of sustainable development is intrinsic to the Constitution of India. So this is the idea of sustainable development. Now let us understand what is the ground level approach. So the traditional concept is that development and ecology are opposed to each other, and without compromising on ecology or environment, economical benefits cannot be reaped. So this is the traditional concept, but this concept has changed now. Now the courts or the judiciary have started seeing sustainable development as a demanding balancing exercise. So it is seen as a balancing exercise. And this balancing exercise requires a calculation of trade-off between environment and economy. So there would be environmental impacts on developmental activities, but at the same time it has got its own economical significance. So a trade-off must be calculated between both this. In other words, any development will have an adverse impact on ecology and environment, and therefore a balance has to be struck. So for what is the balance? The balance should be between environmental impacts and economical significance. So development has got economical significance, but at the same time environmental impacts. So there must be a balance between both this. So this balance necessarily means that if a project will bring in results which are far more useful for people than creating difficulty for a small number of people, then priority must be given to the project. That means we should see the benefits and the impacts and calculate the impact of both, and which overweighs the other should be considered. So it means that the convenience and benefit to a larger section of people should be considered over the difficulties for small numbers. So this is the ground level approach. And now what is the concerns in this highway project or the expressway project? Now here the concern is that the government, the Tamil Nadu government, claims that the economical benefits overweigh the environmental concerns. So this is the argument of the government. But if we closely observe the conditions of the project, we see that it is basically a greenfield project. So a greenfield project means that everything has to be started from the scratch, including the land acquisition. So here it means that a new road will be constructed on virgin land. So everything should start from the beginning. So basically it is a greenfield project. So for a greenfield project, acquiring or conducting an environmental impact assessment is very much necessary. And if the environmental impact assessment is not properly done, this will have a bearing on the environment, on the social and economic life of the landowners. So here, an environmental impact assessment is necessary not only to consider the environmental impacts, but also to consider the economic and social impact on the life of the landowners. This is because a greenfield project has wider consequences not only on the landowners or on the environment, but also on endangered species, on the social and economic life of the landowners, etc. So, in this context, an environmental impact assessment is necessary. But the state government is not ready to conduct an environmental impact assessment before the land acquisition. So, this is the concern in this project. Now, we have seen that earlier the Madras High Court had given its ruling by quashing the proceedings for land acquisition for this project. Now it is upon the Supreme Court on the apex court to decide whether the environmental impacts overweigh the economic interest or whether the economic interest overweighs the environmental impacts. So we will have to see what is the verdict of Supreme Court, and this will also give us a picture on judiciary's approach over such developmental projects and environmental concerns. You can find the PDF of this lecture on our website www.studyiq.com. You can follow my Facebook page for more video updates. You can also write to me at joycy.studyiq@gmail.com for any of your queries and clarifications. Thank you.